Friends, today we will learn how to calculate the first set of a variable. So first set calculation. The first set of a variable tells us the available first terminal information at RHS. Okay, so there are three rules to calculate the first set for a given variable. Suppose there is a production where A is a variable, A is a terminal and alpha is a variable. So the first of A will be the first terminal at the RHS production. So A is the terminal here. So A, small a will be included in the first set of A. The second rule is, suppose we are having a production as A goes to B alpha, where B is a variable, alpha is a variable, A is a variable. The first of A will be first of B. We are assuming here that the B does not contain epsilon. So B is a variable and A is a variable. So first of A will be same as the first of B. The third rule says that, suppose there is a production as A goes to B, alpha, and epsilon belongs to B. So first set of A will be the same as the first set of B, excluding epsilon, union the first set of alpha. So epsilon can replace the B here. So it will be A goes to alpha. The first set of A will be the first set of B minus epsilon union first of alpha. So we will use three rules to calculate the first set of any. We will solve few questions here so that I can make you understand clearly. Okay, so we have been given an example here. So we have been given a grammar here. So and we need to calculate the first set of S, A and B. So the first set of S will include A is a terminal, so we'll apply the first rule here, and the first set of S will contain A only. First set of A will contain B and C. So we need to consider all the productions given for a particular variable, and the first of B will be C. C is a terminal, D is a terminal and epsilon. So it will be C, D and epsilon. So we'll take one more example. In this case, we need to calculate the first set of S. So first set of S will be, A is a variable, it's not a terminal. So first of all, we need to calculate the first set of A, and that will be included in the first set of S. Okay, so first set of A will be A is a terminal and epsilon, because we need to consider all the productions. Okay, so first set of A is A and epsilon. So first set of S will be A, and here epsilon is given. So we can replace A with epsilon. Okay, so it means now the first set of S will include the first set of B also. So we just need to calculate the first set of B also. So first set of B will be C is a terminal, D is a terminal and epsilon, C, D and epsilon. Okay, so first set of S will be calculated as A, C will be taken from here, D and epsilon. Okay, so I'll solve one more question so it will clear concepts completely. So here this is a given grammar here, E, and we need to calculate the first set of E, E dash, okay. So first set of E will be same as the first set of T, because T is a variable. So we need to calculate the first of T before we calculate the first set of E. Okay, So what will be the first set of e dash? It will be plus and epsilon. First set of t, before we calculate the first set of t, we need to calculate the first set of f. Okay, and what is the first set of f? This is id, because it's a terminal. First set of t dash will be star and epsilon. So first set of t will be same as the first set of f. Okay, and f does not contain epsilon, so it will be id only. And first set of e will be the first set of t, and the first set of t is id. That's why the first set of e will have id only. So hope it helps you. Thanks.